various levels. Somebody told me, then if you are going to start your battle against corruption, if you think of somebody corrupt, you can see only your image. Somebody told that whenever, let it be, it is out of humility, it may be also a pinch of truth. For somebody it may be a ton of truth, for somebody it may be a pinch. But certainly it is there. See, four people are corrupt. Those who are corrupt, those who are supported, those who are supported by negligence, those who are supported by innocence. Because the rule or the exemption of innocence cannot be accepted at all. Being a citizen, being a vigilant citizen of a nation, developing nation, it is a duty to be educated well about the reforms of the society, the deforms of the society and profounds of the society. So no innocence, no negligence, no subservience, no dominance, any pretext you cannot justify your non-participation in corruption fight industry. So everybody is born corrupt. So we have to see only our image as the immediate target for corruption fight. And in Africa also, there is one more thing very interesting. It is known as a rent extraction. In Portugal, it is known as rent extraction. In which the total wealth of the nation is being hidden in somewhere overseas investment, like Swiss banks. In Nigeria alone, for the past 4 decades, $400 billion have been extracted and they have been kept somewhere else. It has been naturally done. So likewise, this is in record. Without record, each and every nation's wealth and future and developmental resources are leached and they deposited safely for the single person's benefit or tradition or dynastic benefit in various other banks. That is also we have to take care of very much. And number two, Amritya Sen in his recent lecture has quoted that socio-economical, whatever you say, there is nothing in the society apolitical in nature. Everything is political. Political base is the substantial shelter for all things to grow or to nourish or to perish. So everything is apolitical. Totally, if you see, everything is on the basis of political thing. Because politics is your mass representation. A dynamic form of your individualism is political system. It is more powerful, it is more conscientious, it is more conscious, it is more dynamic and energetic, it is more daring, your potential system of operation, whereas there are the kinetic parts of the political system. So a political system should teach us, train us, to give us the awareness, to lead us, to show the pathway, and also to give the preventive and preemptive measures. Everything is the duty of the political system. But the political system is entirely different. I already told about kleptocracy. Food, air, water, employment, all these resources are to be given by the government. In Bihar, it has been reported by Transparency International that 80% of the food distribution was stolen by the officers themselves, government, authorized agencies and agents themselves, and they sold in black market. So this is the natural situation, but we cannot say that the people are sleeping. The people are vigilant for sensitive issues, sensational issues, not sensible issues. They are not ready to fight for their rights. They are ready to fight for their caste support, for making them to get into reservations, to get them some other benefits, to offer them some other benefits, political standards. They are fighting for the religion, they are fighting for the language. That is a fight in the society. That is integrity in the society, but integrity is a pseudo-integrity. For reasonable things, that's what I told. Sensible things are different from sensational things. The people, they are interested only in sensational issues, not in sensible issues. Bihar, it is a land of fighting and battle, riots happening between people. Nobody has ever protested against this food distribution mismanagement, that 80% of the food, which is to be given to the innocent, they are just diverted and nullified. It has not been taken care of by these people at all. So there are a lot of other things like grants. Getting something more than what you deserve is known as a grant. Embezzlement, that is something known as kickback in corrupted industry. Kickback, you might have heard of kickback in bureaucratic industry. It is an immoral or corruptive bidding. Tenders and bidding, if they are corruptive in nature, that thing is known as kickback. So embezzlement is that, in which you do the same thing, and kickback is that, unholy alliance is that, it has been told by Roosevelt, unholy alliance, in which all the other people who are going to fight, I told it in a seminar on terrorism, that all the terrorists are united, all the patriots, they are living in isolated islands without mobile phones. They are totally disintegrated, with ego clashes, with lack of mutual comparisons, not comparing themselves for a common cause for the utmost productivity of the society. That is the nature of these people. Unholy alliance means naturally the people alliance is there. Organized crimes, well-planned crimes, which is done with state reactors. This is also a problem. How we are going to move that? I want to give you a simple statement. What we are suffering from is known to everybody. Statistical report, strategic report, logistic report, logical report, philosophy of study, ethical study, political view, socio-economical insight, international reports are there. We know what we are, we know what we want. And one of the problem is we don't have a proper driving inner force or an integral force or an invisible force which can make you achieve an agenda. I am not going to tell something which you may not be doing by resources, by publications, research articles, personal experience. Anybody handling business, maybe knowing about what is bride and bridegroom is lesser in significance than bride and bridegroom. Bride and bridegroom, that is having more significance without which the eco-monial, like matrimonial relation is made by bride and bridegroom. Bride and bridegroom, they make the eco-monial relationship between people. It is well experienced by people. Well, people are well subjected, victimized by those things. We know everything. The only thing is that should be a driving force. Part of the driving force, what we are going to do is the essence of today's lecture. Number one, he has already mentioned that there is no transparency. Not only the Right Information Act is there. But for how many people it is accessible, how many people are so talented to use that, how many people are so patient and so alert to use that, that is the issue. So Right to Information Act is one of the transparency facilities. And number two, apart from that, freedom of speech and expression to media and individuals should be there. These are some research-oriented resolutions that have been passed for curbing, controlling, criticizing, as well as emphasizing the drive out of corruption in the country. By a slow process. At first we have control, second is mitigation, third is total extirpation of the same thing in the society. That is a gradual thing. So first thing is to get transparency. And the second thing is to have expression as well as speech freedom. And the third thing is very simple. We should have proper auditing itself. Lot of other people talking about corruption or mismanagement in everywhere. They don't have proper accounting, auditing, systematization, and orderliness in their execution. How they can come out over others? They can hear it or speak it as a past time. Or they time pass. Unless they cannot do that. So personal auditing and personal accountability should be established for people. Fourth thing is very important. It is known as magnification or measurement. We should measure what is character and it should be known. Because if somebody is saying 100 rupees, 1000 rupees, it may not be so magnified. If somebody says that 1 trillion crores is the annual measurement given by Transparency International for the corruption status. $1 trillion. So if you see a mega figure, it is thought that unless these mega figures are produced, are provocative, if you elect thinkable, intelligible, suitable personalities, it is not going to reach a small figures at all. If something is elevated, magnified, and give a colossal structure, a conspicuous structure, they think that it will create an enthusiasm to know more. It will create or induce the courage and bravery to take steps. The third thing, it will create involvement for the person to see that he is not corrupt and he will not allow corruption also. So this measurement or magnification of the corruption figures, it should be given. Fifth thing is tax haven. Whenever there is a taxation, every country is promoting countries like